The aim of the ASTEROID project is to improve the accuracy of vision tests in children with particular forms of visual impairment.
The most common eye diseases in children are squint, which is sometimes known as strabismus, and amblyopia, which is sometimes called lazy eye. A squint means that the eyes of the child aren't lined up together. One of the problems that causes is a reduction in stereo vision or 3D vision. In order to see things in stereo depth, you need your eyes to be aligned. So if they're not lined up with each other, then you lose stereo vision. The treatment is to improve their stereo vision by lining their eyes up better. And you can sometimes do that with glasses, and you can sometimes do that with eye muscle surgery.
In children with these conditions, it's really important to measure their stereo or 3D depth perception, because that tells us how well their two eyes are working together. And we can see if that's maybe getting worse as their condition progresses, or hopefully getting better due to the treatment they're receiving. In the last few years, tablet computers have become available, which can display 3D without the need for glasses. And this is really useful, because trying to persuade a small child to wear glasses can be problematic. If you're presenting a test on a computer, it opens up a whole range of complex statistical techniques which automatically work out what the best level of difficulty is for that particular patient based on all the answers they've given so far.
I'm Stuart Verrill and I run Fluid Pixel. We've been brought onto the project to lend our expertise on how to make the concept fun and interesting. As well as being a scientific project, it's also got to be engaging for the kids who are using it, and so we're bringing our expertise from games through to the science side and trying to merge them together and make it really interesting for the kids to play.
Our responsibility on this project is to put together the engine technology to ensure we lock in on the eyes of the individual looking at the tablet, and we can determine how far away the individual is from the tablet. And by doing that, we can ensure that the image that is produced is actually what we expect it to be in 3D terms.
Patient and public involvement is a really important part of our project. I often go to the Newcastle Eye Centre to talk with the optometrists to hear what they think of the current version we have. I also organise workshops for children where they can have a go with the game to find out whether they find it fun, whether they find it engaging.